Hey guys, my name is Akash. I'm a Microsoft Certified Professional and I have been working with Microsoft Services since last 10 years. Today, I'm going to show you how you can make use of Graph APIs in Power Automate. The agenda of this tutorial will be to show you how you can make use of Graph APIs in Power Automate and what all sort of information will be required. We will also check how you can authenticate with the corresponding Graph API. In the end, I'll show you how you can handle the large dataset from your Graph APIs. So without any delay, let's do it. I'm on the homepage of Power Automate. I'll click Create and I will choose Instant Cloud Flow. I will choose to start it manually and I will name it Get AD Users. I'll press Create button. Now I have an empty flow, which is doing nothing. I'll add a new step. I will choose HTTP connector. Just before we proceed, please keep in mind that HTTP connector is a premium connector. And if you don't know already, premium connectors need separate license. If your organization already have it, it's completely fine. Otherwise, you should check it first. I'll add a link in the description if you want to learn more about Power Automate licensing models. So going back to our flow, for demo purpose, I'm going to use Graph API to fetch all users from my AD. This is the Microsoft page with information about Graph API to get all users from an Active Directory. On top, it says this API retrieves a list of user objects. That means it will fetch me the details of all the users. Then we have a section called Permission. I'm going to get back to this section later on when we will use it. If we go a little more down, we have a section called HTTP Request. This section shows us the suffix part of the actual endpoint of Graph API. Microsoft has done a good job here by adding some examples. So let's check one example. The first one is a basic call to get all the users from Active Directory. If we go a little more down, we can check some other examples. The additional query parameters are to select few fields out of a bunch of user profile properties. And filter is used to return me the results based on a filter criteria, which I'll pass here in the query. An even more simpler example of filter is listed below. Here you can see we are filtering the users whose display name starts with A. Likewise, you can use all sort of query parameters as per your requirement. In my demo, I'm going to keep it really, very simple. So let's go back to the flow. In the method, I will select get, as we might have seen that in the Microsoft page, the request is of get type. In the URI, I will paste list user Graph API endpoint and I want to select only ID, display name and email for a user. Now let's talk about authentication. Graph API always need to authenticate if the request is from the legitimate user or not. So one way to authenticate is to use access tokens or bearer tokens. We pass access token in headers here, but this will need an additional step for me to generate the access token before I can even call a Graph API. So this seems like an additional step for me to do. I don't want to do this. So I will check out my advanced options. None is already selected as a default authentication method. I don't want to use none. I want to use Active Directory authentication. With Active Directory authentication, I can directly authenticate my credentials with Graph API, and I do not need to use headers, queries, a body of the of this action. In the authority field, we will pass the authority to login.microsoft.com to authenticate us. In the tenant field, you need to pass tenant ID. To obtain tenant ID, you need to go to Azure portal. You go to homes. You need to then go to Active Directories. On the overview page of your Active Directory, you will see the tenant ID. You will copy from here, go back to your flow, and paste it in tenant field. In the audience field, you will have graph.microsoft.com. In the credential type, we will keep it as it is. Then we are left with client ID and secret. Client ID and secret are part of app-only authentication. For this demo, I expect that you already know basics of app-only authentication. But if you want to know more about it, I have shared the link in the description. You can also let me know in comments if you want me to create a separate tutorial on app-only authentication. Now let's get back to how we can and where we can get the client ID and secret from. For this, you need to go to Azure portal again. In your Active Directory, you can see in the left navigation, there is an option called app registration. In the app registration, you need to register your app from new registration option. I already have an app. This is my app, which I want to use. On the overview page of the app, under essential section, you can see there is something called application ID. You can copy this ID, go back to your flow, and paste it in the client ID field. For secret, you need to go back to your app again. In certificate and secret on the left navigation, you can see there is a section called client secrets. If you already have a secret, you can use it, but you can also create a new client secret. In here, you can choose when do you want your client secret to expire. By default, you have 1 year, 2 year, or never. For this demo, I'm going to choose never. Now this will show me the client secret value. I can copy it from here, go back to my flow, and paste it in secret. So every information to this action is provided, and we are good to go and test. But wait, are we really done? Remember, in the Microsoft Graph API page, I said we'll discuss more about permissions. So let's go and see what it says. So the permission section is talking about some sort of permissions are required to call this API. Then there is a small table under it with two columns, permission type and permission scope. And it is talking about delegate permissions, application permissions, some work or school account. But what is all this? This is nothing but actually part of app only authentication. If we go back to our flow and take a closer look here, in the client ID, we are using the application ID, which we created in Azure AD. Here, I'm talking about this application. So we are using this app's credentials, application ID and client secret in the flow. We need to make sure that this application has sufficient permissions to make this call. And how can we do that? Let's go back to the post. This section says one of the following permission is required to call this API. By one of this means either this one or this one. Personal Microsoft account is not supported, which is already mentioned here. We are going to use application permissions. And it's just because the difference between the delegate permissions and application permission type. Again, for the detailed information, I can prepare a separate tutorial, but I cannot cover all the detailed information here. Otherwise, this video will be so long than I expect it to be. But here in for application permission, it says the scope of the permission should be user.read.all, user.write.all, directory.read.all, directory.readwrite.all. How we can make sure that our application have these permissions? For this, we will go to our app in the API permission. We can make sure if these permissions are already here. If you are creating this application from scratch, you may not have these permissions already. In that case, you can add the permissions from here. Choose Microsoft Graph API, choose application permissions. And from here, you will see a lot of permissions listed here. And you have to select these permissions and click add permissions in the bottom. After you are done with adding required permissions, you will also need to grant admin consent to these permissions. But once the grant is done, your flow is good to go and you can test it by saving it. So let's save it and test it from the top right. You can see the flow ran successfully. Let's check the output of this HTTP connector. We can see in the body, there are so many users this request has given me. Test user 1, 2, demo account, my account, etc. My tenant has a few users in Active Directory. So for such a small tenant, you may not even face any problem with Graph API record size limit. By the way, Graph API can fetch you only 1,000 records at a time. If you want to fetch more than 1,000 records, you have to do this in multiple batches. And you know what? Graph API already helps us by providing the link to the next batch. So that means the URL for the next batch is already prepared and given to us. And we don't actually need to bother about how will I get the next batch of my original request. To understand more, let's check the response body again. In the response body, you can see there is something called OData next link. Next time, you need to make call to this URL and you keep doing this in a loop until you do not find OData next link. To do this, let's edit the workflow. I have to initialize two variables. In the variable URL, I will keep my original URL, which I need to call to in my HTTP connection. So I will paste my URL in the URL variable. In my second variable called status, I will keep track of the presence of OData next link in the response body. And now I will start a loop. I will type do until and select this. In my do until loop, I will run this loop until the status value is equals to false. So I need to make a continuous calls to Graph API until I get all my records in a loop. So I'll drag HTTP action inside do until. Now in the URI, in the HTTP action, I'll get the values from the variable URL in URI field instead of having a static value, because I will keep updating the value of variable URL with the next set of records. Now I need to check if the returned data has any value or not. For this, I will check the length of the data returned greater than zero. So if the length of the data returned is greater than zero, that means I have the data and I want to make call to the next batch. But if the length of the data is zero, then I want to stop the loop. So to stop the loop, I will set variable status to false. And if the length of the data is greater than zero, then we want to set the variable URI with OData link from the response body, so that next time when HTTP will run, it will use OData next link. This completes our flow. Now save it and test it. We can see the loop ran two times. First time, it was the original URL which we had, and in the response body, we saw OData next link. Second time, HTTP action made a call to OData next link, and this time the value is null. That means the length of the data is zero. And this time, the condition sent the flow on the right side and set the status variable to false. And that's why we did not see any instance running of this loop third time. I hope this video helped you to understand how to use Graph APIs in Power Automate and you learned something new. If you found this video useful, give it a like. And if you want to keep up with all the latest quick tip videos that I'll keep releasing, subscribe to my channel.